Now you see, are you able to see the screen, what I'm typing here?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Spartan 3E FPGA board. This data sheet is there, FPGA board is there, user guide is there. So this particular device, this is XC3S500E. So like that, if you type, so what happens is they will provide you this data sheets. This data sheet. In that the data sheet, they will mention for what applications they actually developed this FPGA. So we have to consult this FPGA, and the target applications they will mention in that manual. This is this sort of PDF. They somewhere they will mention target applications. So we have to go through this thoroughly. And we have to understand that our particular design we are targeting, suppose a particular design. If that particular design requires whether compatible this board or not, a vague idea, not exact idea, vague idea we will get. After getting that rough idea, vague idea, then we can go to that particular board and we can start working. For example, how we get a vague idea, for example, you see this where I am selecting. Is that are you people able to see what I'm selecting here? Zoom this one. Let me zoom. Now it is good. Let me zoom further. Now it is further good. Now are you able to see what I am selecting here?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. Now you see here, total CLBs, configurable logic blocks here, 1164. Now if you see here, the other device, if you see, 2168. So likewise, this information from where we got actually the CLB information, from this document we got. Now what we do is, we develop our design, we go to our this one here, this design summary report, and in this design summary report, what we do is we study this number of slices occupied here, the area where I'm hovering my mouse, Are you able to see where I'm hovering my mouse?
Yes, sir.
There you see this information that this is number of slices being consumed. Here it is mentioned 4656. Then suppose my design is so huge, it is consuming beyond this 4656 available on this board here. This is the board I have selected, Spartan 3E is the family, and in that device is this 500E. So if you go here, that is your this one here, this document where I was showing earlier, where was the document here? I think here. So this document, if you see, you have here list here, devices list here, this area. So now you have, let us say you have with you this device, this where I am selecting, you have this device. In this device, you have total number of slices, how many mentioned? 4656 in this document. Is it not? 4656 mentioned in this document. Now if you go here, you have 4656 available. This tool also telling, because this device what I have selected is that particular XC3S500E. So for that reason, it is showing 4656. Now the design, let us say this design project what I am working is a big huge project. So this huge project, what happens is it may exceed the available the number of slices also. So at that time, I will come to know utilization will increase 100%, more than 100, 105, 107. It exceeds 100 anyway. The moment it has exceeded 100, then I will come to know that this device is not suitable for my application. Then what you do is you switch to other device. You switch to other device. For example, in this case, this is the device. You may pick this device now. Where you pick this device? Here you change this one here. You change this device 500 to next 1200E, or let us see in a 1200E how many available number of slices are there. So if you go here, this if you see 1200 here, this one number of slices are 867. So now what you do is you select this by clicking here this one, and you change that device to this 1200E. Now you start working again, everything, the timing and all, functional simulation, everything again you verify, because the device you changed means every timing constraint we did not demonstrate it. So, but you have to look into timing constraint also, whether timing is met or not. That we will deal in the next session. I mean, after this course, new course, I will be starting advanced course. In that, you will come to know how to apply the timing constraints. So, that is what all about this one. So, now what we have to do is, since you people have seen that this device, just a moment. I have to seek here help of. So guys, just a moment, we again go to that board now. We see that board here. So now what happens is, meanwhile, by the time, you people able to see this board?
Yes, sir.
So now what is that required is, in the academic side, industry side means, this where I am pointing here, this you see here, this one, these are the four sliding switches here. I have this switches here. So this what we call our academic purpose, these four switches are maximum 32 switches are 32 also possible on this. How 32 possible with these four, I will demonstrate in some other session. But currently what I am telling you people is, if you have MTech project or industry project, then these switches are not going to be much helpful. You have to interface here through the where I am pointing here, the other side. You interface a keyboard, and the keyboard interfacing module you have to write, because the characters what you are typing on the keyboard, that needs to be translated to that English word. So we have to write a keyboard interface module, and then you plug in the keyboard here where I am pointing. And then you start typing, and then this where I'm pointing here, you have VGA plugin also, VGA plugin. So for that also interface module you have to write. So now your actual logic will, top module will interface with a keyboard module and VGA module. So now what happens is, a engineer who is trying to test the hardware will interface with the keyboard and display unit. Instead of this where I am pointing, your LCD unit, possibly this may not be sufficient for industrial applications. In such case, through VGA, where I am pointing here, through VGA they can monitor and they see. So now since our journey is a learning journey, we started with fundamentals. So let us now demonstrate how we actually, a small example, how we configure onto this FPGA board, and how we play with this slider switches here. You have the switches, and how the output is displayed onto this LEDs here, where I am pointing my pencil. There LEDs are there. So how they are working. So that demonstration now we will see. Okay, thank you. So we'll back again to the board after a while. So now you see this one. Is it visible my screen now to everyone?
Yes, sir.
This one able to see you people? Are you able to see this screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now let us go to this one here. That is, so far we have demonstrated a small example here. How do we write our this half adder? This is a simple half adder example. Today we are demonstrating on a board lab. So here, let me zoom it. Let me create a project actually. From beginning I will show, because this is for demonstration purpose I opened early. Now let us say you are creating a project. How do you create a project? From there we will start. So we go here. This IEC design suit 14.7. Everybody able to see this where I'm hovering my mouse?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we click that one. So the moment when we click, in a while this will open up, this application will launch. So thereafter what we have to do is we go to this one file and go to new project, and there you type your since we are demonstrating basic steps, so this is a half adder example. So this is, you now you selected this family divisor. Why we are selecting and all, in the previous videos we talked much about this. So kindly refer on YouTube, we have demonstrated this one, synthesis, simulation, everything. Those videos you will see why we are, how we set this divisor and all. So now just a demonstration how on board how we do. So for that is the session going on. So I am proceeding. Next and finish. Now what you have to do is here, you just right click and then new source and select a Verilog module, and then here is a file, your file HA is the file name I gave because that's the project I'm working on. So now you have to, I'm just removing for my easy readability here. But in the industry, every detail will be there, who has worked on the project, all those details will be there. Let me zoom this bit one a bit for visibility. This is here. Now I type here A comma B comma your sum comma your carry out. So this is a port list area. Now port type declaration. You must be familiar by this time. 2005, according to 2005, how we can declare ports. According to 1995, how we can declare our ports. According to 2005, we call it as a ANSI style. So you must be remembering that, because this information itself we put inside here. So that is according to 2005 language standardization. This assign is a which abstract level can someone speak?
Data flow, sir.
Yes, data flow. So now what is that I am doing, this braces I used and I am putting inside the braces this C naught and some variable. What is that braces here? Can someone speak?
Concatenation.
That's great. We are concatenating this one. Just last two sessions we have seen operators. So in that operators, this has come concatenation. So now we have done this description of the hardware. We don't know whether this description is correct or not. So if you don't know, this is simple example. So we are just feeling that it is anyway going to work. But a complex design example, definitely no one will be sure about that. So what is the engineering, what is the standard practice? Standard practice is, anyone? What is the standard practice? Whether you got my question or not, my question is, we described our module. Now what is next? That is technically called?
Functional simulation.
That's great. That is functional simulation. So after functional simulation, we will not be happy. We also have to carry out timing simulation also. That timing simulation in advanced course we will cover. But that is good answer, functional simulation. So we perform functional simulation. Since we already know how to perform functional simulation, today's agenda is to demonstrate on the board. So that's why we are skipping that portion. The test bench writing and simulating, that portion we are skipping just for the reason that we want, our agenda is today to demonstrate. Can someone mute? Somebody, I have to check. Okay, so let us back here. So now this one here, everybody might have got the point. We are actually, we have to perform functional simulation, but we are skipping that portion because we want to demonstrate onto the board. So for that, steps are, guys, These are the steps now. What we have to do is, you see here, this is user constraints. Everybody able to see this? You can unmute and immediately mute also. User constraints, everybody able to see this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. Yeah, so this user constraints, we have to tell the tool that on this board is there, no? With us, this board is there. On this board, which pin we are going to use as a input pin? Which pin you are going to use as a output pin? That information we have to provide. So that information, if you go here again, this board here. So they will give information like you have to type here board manual, something like that. Board manual, something like that. To type, then you will get a PDF or possibly this one. So how we know what is input pin, what is output pin? This is how you have to search. You should not depend upon anyone. That's the my idea of starting this delivery of this sessions is, you should be aware of everything. You should not depend on the institutes. Institutes are cheating the students and learners. So this board, this document, UG 230 PDF, this board contains this information. Like suppose say push button switches, if you go push button, see, nicely, it's a nice document, you see. You see, this is a push button. I was talking about the rotary push button switch is there. So that one here, I shown beside this portion, you remember I have shown the board. This one, you remember where I'm hovering mouse? This is the LCD screen, that this portion. Where is that? Very beginning here. You remember when I shown this one to you? Yes?
Yes, sir.
So here, this side here, you have this rotary switch here, this one. These are buttons, push buttons, where I'm hovering my mouse. These are, again, switches. And these are where I'm having LED. So nice document Xilinx people have provided us. So now what we have to do is, suppose say I have discrete LED is there, push button switches are there. So now I go to the push button switches. You see UCF. UCF means user constraint file. User constraints file location. So this, if you go here, you see this one here, net, this LOC, everything they have mentioned here. This one, this is how we interface. Suppose I want to interface as this particular switch. Let me take this one here, whether it is going to help me or not, I don't know. Last time I tried, but it was... coming. Just a moment. Yeah. Now let me try. This one, where I am rounding. This, you see here where I am rounding?
Yes, sir.
This one, yeah. This one has got some number, something like a L14, maybe like that. And this one, if you see here, this particular what we call this LED. This may be having something, let us say this is, I don't know whether correct or not, but telling you people that some F15 like that. Everything, even this push button switch, this has got some number, maybe, I don't know, but I'm just telling you M14. How do you come to know that this is M14, this is F15, this is L14? You have to consult that document. This document you have to consult. Without consulting this document, there is no way that you are going to learn. Don't depend upon the institutes. They will cheat you. They will take money from you. So you learn on your own. Then you will become a true engineer. So now the point here is, this one here, I was just telling you, where here, this, if you go here, push button switches here. push button switches. Likewise, everything has got some or the other name. Some are the other name here. Just let me go to one more time here. Push button switches. These are the push button switches. These are the locations here. So likewise, one more time here. This is the contents here. From the contents, this is the slide switches. These slide switches, earlier I have shown you here on the board here. This portion. These are the slide switches. So now my intention is to demonstrate using these slide switches and these LEDs. So for that, what information I need? Pin information I need. This two, if I want to make, this is A and this one is a B. And this one is a left-hand side LED as a sum, and right-hand side LED as a sum, left-hand LED as a carry. So I need to know the pin, the numbers here, so location numbers. So that is, I will come to know through this document. If I go here, slide switches, now these are the slide switches. If I want to use this switch, S0, then that is the L13 I have to use in my code. And if I want to use this particular switch, then that is SW1, that is this switch one, the pin is L14. Like that, I have to tell in my user constraint file. This is the thing that I'm trying to convey you people. Now the second point is, I want to make use of LEDs. So I have to go again to that starting contents where the LEDs are here. So you see the discrete LEDs here, the way slide switches here, we have discrete LEDs. Let us go to the discrete LEDs. If you go to the discrete LEDs, you have, I thought of using this extreme right as a sum and this one as a carry out. So I have here F12 and E2. So now from this document, I got information. Now what I do, I go back here. Let me close this previously opened this one. This I previously opened. Okay. Now this was the portion I was demonstrating you people. So now you come to this one here. You had to select your module here. After selecting module, this one synthesis, implement design, you see here, configure target device, you expand this one. Everybody able to see there? This screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, in this, these are the tools, you know, synthesis, this is one tool. Implement design, this is another tool. In this tool, we have sub tools. One is a translate tool, one is a map tool, one is a place and route tool. Now, if you come like that, here, configure, you have some tools here. Two tools are there. One is a generate target PROM, and ACE file and manage configuration project impact. This is another tool. Now the point here is, this PROM, you know, everyone knows there that, let me take this paint. If you put something into the into this one, that is ROM, it's a read-only memory. If you put something inside this one, if you power off, then also the contents will stay retained inside the memory. The moment when you power on, then you can load them here. You can load them back here. But if you use the other device called RAM, the moment you power off, contents will go. You cannot load here. Contents will go. So that's why we call it is a volatile and non-volatile. This is a non-volatile and this is a volatile. So we had to remember this too. So why? Because this, this here two are there. We can generate a file. Now if I go particularly this one here, I just want to show you people everything here. I have, if you see where I'm hovering my mouse, see users, Acer, desktop, Verilog Online, HA2, there where this project is there. Let us go to that section. This is the Verilog Online and there HA2. Now you see everybody there. You see, remember here, you have here, don't have, what you don't have is star dot bit if you type that one, store dot quick, no items match your search. See where I have searched into that portion. Which portion? Again, this project portion, where I have my project here, HA. In this portion, this is the, see, Verilog online. What I am searching? I'm searching store dot bit. Now, what is the display? No items match your search. Now, what happens is, when you try to configure your FPGA, you have to generate a programming file. You have to generate programming file. This one you have to generate. The moment you generate this file, that is a dot bit extension. And we have different file extension. If you want to program this VROM, that is different extension. So, but generally we want to configure in the volatile memory, that is a dot bit file will do. So the thing is, the moment when we run this generic programming file, in this area where I was searching here dot bit, no items match your search. Now it will come automatically. See how it is going to come. What is going to come here? That file is going to come, dot bit file. But what I want to do, even before generating dot bit file, I just want to constrain here this, user constraints. Here I want to constrain. This is a pre-synthesis and a post-synthesis. Either one is okay. The very meaning is telling here pre-synthesis, before synthesizing, running this step itself. IO pin planning want to do, that is what, in that case, you can run this one. You can run this post-synthesis, IO planning, this tool you have to run. There are two tools here. Why this pre-synthesis IO planning, why this post-synthesis IO planning and all advanced topics? For example, but just to give you a glimpse of that, I have something called some logic, some blue logic is sitting here. And my IO, that is input output is here. My output is here. And this blue logic, what is there here, is actually giving something to this output. Now, what I found here after going, running this, if you see this mapping, place and route, this you can open these tools, advanced course, that's why I'm not touching this one, but giving you just a glimpse of that. If you go here, analyze timing is there, static timing is there, advanced topic, all this will cover course. But what my intention is, this portion, if you have some portion left here, not used, we can instruct that tool to put this blue logic in this portion. We can instruct that tool. Because of that, what happens is, now the area is only this. So meaning what? This timing, this may be causing some timing issue. This portion may be causing some timing issue, delay. We noticed that this portion actually tool did not use intelligently. Manual intervention was required there. Then we tell the tool that this blue logic you can put here. Thereby, this timing issue we can resolve. So that is what this IO. Now, IO, actually this IO, input output, where it is actually here, right? So that is what this portion. Pre-synthesis, before synthesis only, where do you want to place your IOs? You can plan. After synthesis, then timing issues will come. At that time, you may not like you placing your IO this one. This possibility may not be there. The other possibility is here, suppose some logic already existing. This portion, you cannot move this. And this logic, what is existing here, is not making use of this IO. Now, I don't want this to be my IO. I want one unused IO port here to be my output port for this blue logic. This blue logic, instead of going all the way all the way from here to here, this GlueLogic is giving output to this port. What I want to instruct Baba tool, don't use this as my output port, rather you use this one here. Thereby again I could able to tackle my timing issue. So that's the pre-synthesis and post-synthesis I/O plannings means here, this one. But since our example, design example is half adder is not going to cause much difficulty for us, because it's after all simple example. So what we do is either way is okay for us. Let us run this one. If you run this one, you notice here where I'm hovering my mouse is a running synthesis. So everything will run. So let us wait for a while. Now a prompt has come to the new guys here. Carefully read this one. This process requires that an implementation constraint file UCF be added to the project and associated with the selected design module, this design module. Would you like Project Navigator to automatically create UCF, user constraint file, this implementation constraint file, ICF, it would have been ICF, but we say it UCF, that is user constraint file. This is a tool is saying implementation constraint file. So it's okay. So now, would you like Project Navigator to automatically create UCF and add it to the project at this time? If you select no, you will need to create or add an existing UCF to the project before running this process. If you click this one, then manually you have to. If you click yes, then this tool will automatically add. Where it will add here, you see earlier there was no plus sign here in this project. Now you design module, at this design module, now if you expand this one, you see ha.ucf. With this module name, there is a UCF, user constraint file, been created. Now what I am doing is I can open this one here by clicking here this one. If I click here where is that? If I click this one, what it is asking me, want to open in the text editor? Suppose if I click yes, now this is your UCF file. You see ha.ucf where I'm hovering my mouse. It's empty. We did not put anything. What we had to put actually, we have to put this one. This, you know, this information, this which pin I want to use, like input or output. This information, I have to put where I have to put in this area, that is, this area I want to put. I have to put here manually, but without manually, automatically the tool itself here, if you see the other one here, this is called another tool by the Xilinx only, plan ahead tool. This tool, if you expand here, this one, you see your port A, your port B, your ports CO, your port sum. Are you able to see all these ports here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now what we do under this area site here, if you click here, you see a huge number of things are coming out here like this. So my idea is actually is in this here user constraint, what I want to pick is I want to pick this slide switch. So I in this slide switches I have the information here somewhere, this slide switch information. If I go here, I have L13 and L14. So I want to use this L13 as a L14 as a B. So for that reason, what I do, I go here to the site again. Here, L13, see, because this is the, so I am going here again. I pick L13, where my L13 is. You can type also, that will come automatically. L13. So this is L13. So now you select that one there. So after that, this one you see here, this you fix it. So if you fix, that is fixed here. Now at that position, lock to that L13, this A is locked. Now go to the B. B here, if you see, where is that? Here. I want to use this L14. L14 as a B. So now I go here. This one. I type simply, instead of searching scrolling like that, I type simply L14. It will come like that, there. So it has come now. So I this is locked again. Now it is going to the CO. So now I go again here. This time what I want to do is, I want to use these LEDs. So for that, I just go here again in the manual, where my LEDs are. Here are my discrete LEDs. I go there. You see this LED section here, total, you count LD0 to LD7. Total 8 LEDs are here. Now F14 and E12. I zoom this way. Yes. Yeah, F12. That I want to use as a sum. So for that, I go here, F12 for, at the sum. So at the sum, what is that I thought of? I thought of this one, F12. F12 sum. So F12 sum. Now it's fixed. So now I go to this one here, E12. That is carry out, this one. So E12. So E12. The moment I click here, you might have observed here something happening. Those pins are actually binded here. We can zoom this one and we can see where these are binded. Now this is done. I had to save this one here. I save this one, save constraints here. So this is saving design constraints here. Now I go back here where I close this one. This is saying, do you want to reload? Yes, reload. So now you go to this one here, UCF. Want to open with again the text editor? Yes. Now you see everything has come. Are you able to see? Earlier it was blank. Now it is filled. Able to see you guys there?
Yes, sir.
So this is actually manually also we can do without this tool help, that is a plan ahead tool help. We can do manually if you remember this syntax. But the reason why we are taking help of this tool is, you see here further, we did not talk about this further. LV, CMOS, here 25 or 2.5 VC. We did not talk. These are advanced course topics. We are not touching here. If you go to this manual here and go to this portion, just a minute. Here, if you go UCF here, anywhere you go, just UCF. If you go here, what is there? Apart from NET, this one, you have IO standard LVTTL pull up. This is something to do with your design requirements. So those design requirements and what that something is to do with your design and all. Those are advanced topics. We are not going to discuss this one. So, but they are, with the help of this tool, easily manageable. Instead typing manually here, remembering, hardly anyone remembers all that syntax here, this syntax anyone remembers hardly. So that's why this tool helps us to, select according to requirement, all this, whether to full type here to set up, not all that. So this tool helps us plan ahead tool. Now we have done the basic thing here, that what is needs to be set here. So now we go to this one here. What we do is this time we have to generate our programming file. You see the tick marks here. You keep watching here, the observation is required. You see observation tick here. This tick is only with synthesis. No implement design tick, no any other inside this translate map, there is no tick. For that reason, you will go to your Verilog, this where your project folder is there. These were not there, so many. Now so many, whether the .bit file is there or not. It will not be there because we did not create that. So if you start .bit, you see no items match your search. Now what we do is, we go here, straight we click inside the implement design, we generate programming file, we create, we double click this. Now translate, everything is happening. So let us wait for a while. that is the implement design is done. That's why there is a tick mark you see. Now generate timing, you see carefully observe the generate timing. Now generate bit stream, it is generating that bit stream file, that bit file extension. Done now. You see now your tick marks here, synthesis done, implement design done, generate programming file tick marks all you see. Nice tick marks have come. Now let us go to that folder. Which is that? I think here. This one. You see now that ha.bit file. Everybody able to see now?
Yes, sir.
This bit file is the file that is required to configure our FPGA. Earlier this file was not there in our project folder. Now it has come. This bit file includes information of this design, that is this functionality information, how many ports are there, what are the input ports, what are the output ports, and what functionality, and on board which port is binded to which switch, that information also will be there in this dot bit file. So this bit file contains that information. Now if you try to open this file, you cannot read this one. See, let us open. You cannot read this. No one can read this actually. Tool will see. Are you able to see? Everybody there able to see?
Yes, sir.
We cannot read this one. So that only that chip understands that. That chip understands. So let us go to the chip now. So for going to the chip here, we have to go to this configure target device. This analyze design using chip scope is advanced, of course. We have another tool called chip scope. So through chip scope also, we can access the signals. What is happening inside the chip, we can observe. So this is part of the advanced course, not basic level. So we are not touching this course. Let us go to this configure target device. So if you click this, no impact project file exists, click OK to open impact. Impact is a tool, as I said. So we are opening this tool now. So the tool will come. So let us wait for the tool. If it pops up, if everything is all right in my computer, then that should pop like this. So it has come now like this. So now what I do is, you see the boundary scan. I am just clicking this boundary scan. So I click it, the boundary scan. Right click to add devices. Actually, since I powered on here, it should show up here actually. So I'm going to initialize chainnet. What I'm doing, earlier it was not showing anything here in this white space. It was grayed actually. I clicked on boundary scan, then this area has come. Now right clicking, initialize chain, I am clicking on that. If my device is detected by my computer, if cable is also supporting, there's no flaw, then everything will be fine. So, but very unfortunately, here you see, cannot find cable, check up cable setup. So that's the issue. So you shouldn't be going panic. What you have to do, you have to understand the issues here. You have to study why it is not behaving like that. Now you try again, plugging in, plugging out. So all that things you have to do. So guys, here, what I do is now, because I have to debug, I think, I have to power on this, I have to debug my, you see the changes. Sounds, are you getting sounds, something, the moment I am turning off, some sounds are coming. Are you able to listen to those sounds? Are you there, are you people?
Yes, sir.
So are you able to sense those some sounds? Is it like a device plug in, plug out, some sort of sounds? No,
yes,
not
sir.
Coming? Okay. So I'm just trying to plug in that. And now, so what is the problem is, these require some drivers. So how do you debug that? You go to this one here, you have your PC, go to this, properties, and somehow we have to get into the, not properties then, have to get into that man devices then. So you should able to see this Xilinx drivers there. If not there, then we have to get somehow. Then just I'm letting you know what I'm doing here, how I'm debugging. So here, if you go device manager, now here somewhere here, I think programming cables. If you see this one is there here. So one more time, what I do, I scan for hardware changes. Now let us see whether this some magic happens here. I should see a few more things here. So cable auto connection failed. I should able to see the devices actually. So that is a cable problem, some problem. Let me change the port otherwise. I just change the port. We change the port. Maybe my USB port has got some problem. Okay, I plug it in. Let me see what happens. What is that I can do is I have to change number 4 here. Okay, guys, not an issue. I will resolve this one. Now, what is that? I will tell you and I will conclude today's session. Let me conclude today's session. What is that next step is? Let me put this right in the... Now, what happens here? I see here my Xilinx device, this device. Which device? This device. This Spartan 3E XC3S500E. This one will be seen where here as an icon here. As a what I see now, I will just let me take this one. So now I see here one Xilinx XC500E device here. Now I see another chip here, that is CPLD chip. CPLD chip. What is going to happen? That I am telling you people. And this is what exactly going to happen. Tomorrow I will rectify this one and I will demonstrate. And here some ROM will be there, that PROM. Some PROM will be there. So these devices are connected in this fashion. It will show like this. Something like that it will show. Okay. Now, what I had to do is, on this chip, because I want to configure my FPGA, right? My FPGA chip, I want to configure. I don't want to configure my CPLD. I don't want to configure my PROM. I want to configure my FPGA. This is my FPGA. So what I do is, I right-click here. After right-clicking in this portion, what happens is, program. Some sort of this will be there. I have to select that program. It will ask which file, where is that file is. So that file I have to locate here. Just a moment, I have to come out of here. I have to select this .bit file. Everybody able to see this this one? what is I'm doing. Able to see?
Yes, sir.
So this dart bit file you have to select. What you have to do on right, you have to right click here. To right click here, there is a something, the way you see here, these things are coming like. So what it comes, program the device, something will come. Then you have to browse. It will give the browse option also. Then you have to browse to that file, that is .bit file. Then it will ask here to pick any other file for this device also. That file extension is different, it will show up there. You have to click there, bypass. Their option will come bypass. And here it will show related to this file, this device, there is a file. Want to pick that file, want to browse for that also. Then you have to click there also bypass. So meaning what, that file .bit file here it will show up. Here it will show up. Your .bit file will show up only with this device. Only with this device. Now what you have to do after bypass. Now again one more time you right click. Now you click on the program. So done. A message will come. What message will come? Here, program succeeded. Program succeeded. Message will come. So you have done with your configuration now. Now what you have to do is, you have to go to your device. Earlier, what I was showing you people. I'm sorry. You have to go to this one. You have to go to this portion. I was showing this while through the camera, I was showing this. So you go there, since you have decided this is my A, this is B, you play with this. One, both down, 0, 0, then obviously your carry 0, some 0. One up, the other 0. So obviously some 1 carries 0. Then the other one is up, the other one is 0. Now your sum is still 1 and carry is still 0. Both up. Now your carry is 1, sum is 0. That is what actually displayed on the board. I thought of going till that point, but because I did not check this one before presenting, so I ended up with having some technical glitch.